10, UW-Stevens Point continues to see an increase in COVID-19 cases. So will the Pointers transition to online classes like other UW schools? News 9's Sarah McGrew is in Stevens Point with what you need to know.
There have been over 200 COVID-19 cases here on campus, but students tell me they're hoping they can finish the semester in person.
To go virtual or not? That's the question many colleges and universities are facing as COVID-19 outbreaks hit campuses across the country, including in Stevens Point. While UWSP hasn't gotten to that point yet, the university says it's prepared to make the transition.
Our faculty actually designed two sets of classes, one version for in-person conversation and learning, and one for online or virtual conversation.
So what do students think about the possibility of virtual learning?
I'm concerned that it will happen, and I hope that it doesn't.
I hope it does not.
I don't think it would really be too much of a difference at this point, just because a lot of things are already online.
Depending on whether or not the university transitions to online learning is dependent on a few things:
the total number of cases, ICU capacity in local hospitals, and the university's capacity to quarantine and isolate students.
Over 85% of those beds are open and available for use.
While the university does have quarantine space, Portage County as a whole has seen a recent surge in cases, which weighs on the available public health resources.
And then we're in ongoing conversations almost daily with our colleagues, public health colleagues.
Overall, he says he's happy with the behaviors he's seen from students, and students seem to feel the same way.
I'm proud of how we're handling it compared to other schools because I think we're doing pretty well.
The university does have a COVID-19 dashboard where you can find a daily count of cases and resources for the university community. I'll have a link up on our website. In Stevens Point, Sarah McGrew, News 9, WAOW.